For the 20 assembly constituencies, the 842 are the polling stations. So altogether our number of locations are 583. As per the last published electoral list, the total number of electors is 5,53,206. As announced by the Honorable Election Commission of India, the notification will be issued on 28/3/2019. Nominations will start from that day. The last date for receipt of nominations will be 4/4/2019 till 3 p.m. Withdrawal date is 8/4/2019 and the date of poll is 23/4/2019. Date of counting is 23/5/2019. Next in the schedule is the randomization of the EVMs, that is the machinery, the machines of CU, BU and VVPAT, which are now with the RO, will be distributed among the assembly constituencies in the first randomization. On the pre-poll day, these machines will be moved to the respective polling stations. So commissioning will also happen at the level of the AROs. So this is as per the ECI's instructions, we will be carrying it on. We are prepared towards that also. Since nominations will start from the 28th of March, necessary arrangements have been made to receive the nominations. First, there will be a preliminary scrutiny. Scrutiny will only mean that the checklist is complied with. It is not a detailed scrutiny. Once the nomination is submitted at the level of an ARO, it will be checked if all details have been filled. Thereafter, the candidates will be asked to pay the security deposit, after which they will submit the nomination form. This is an online solution wherein the political parties can apply for permissions online through Suvidha. The ARO will receive the application, they will process it, and these applications have to be submitted 48 hours prior to the event. So within 24 hours, the ARO will have to process it and act on the application. Categories in which postal ballot is permitted, that is, they are registered elector, but on that day if they have a poll duty by which they will not be able to physically go to their polling station, assigned polling station, and cast their vote, such kind of people are given postal ballots. The focus of course is on inclusive elections, so we are encouraging different segments of the population to come and vote. To this extent, we have had one awareness session with the visually impaired. We are also planning for another session with the hearing impaired, so that PWDs, that is persons with disabilities, will be facilitated for participating in the process of election.